Welcome to The Big Sheep. So you may have just come from my vlog from the Milky Way Adventure Park. I'm down here in Devon doing various different theme parks and attractions, and today I'm doing two different parks in the same day. I've just spent 3 hours up there. I've done the three different roller coasters, a few of the other experiences as well, a fantastic sci-fi exhibition, and there's so much more to discover. It's only about 7 miles away from The Big Sheep, so it's only took me about 15 minutes to get here. And yeah, this looks like a right cute little park, this does. It used to be just a farm, and then in 1988 it was transformed into a full-on visitor attraction. There's now various different rides, shows, lots and lots of animal experiences, and yeah, I'm here for one reason really, and that is of course to have a look round, but get on their largest roller coaster, which is located just over there, and it's called Rampage, and I'll be going on that shortly. Here we are, here is The Big Sheep. Look, there's loads of them down here. Hello. This looks like the sort of place I'm gonna have to come back with Charlotte at some point. She loves her animals. Hello, say hello to the viewers. Aww, aren't they cute? Oh, big sheep. And then of course you got the Gruff's Goatal over there. Look at that. All the goats sitting at the top. Oh, as soon as I said that, that goat then, did you see him move on the little perch? Look at them all. This is like Charlotte's ideal place to come. Oh my God. She'd love it. Hello. You gonna say hello to the viewers? Oh, they're interactive goats as well. They love it. Oh, little cute one. Hello. But yeah, here's a look at the map. Like I say, it's cost me around £11.50, I think it was, booked online. So not too bad at all. I came in at the entrance down here. Free parking at this one as well. Same as the Milky Way. Here you can see you've got some rides on the top side of the park there. You've got the Rampage roller coaster that opened here in 2016. There's a tractor track that was just behind me, the Twister, a Swan Lake with some pedalos. There's some sort of farm safari ride that will go on. Of course, have a little walk around here, see all the different play areas. Bo Peep's Cafe, Splash Zone, go-karts up there, pony rides, mini self-drive tractors. Loads of things here to do. Again, it's a family park, mainly for the kids, but I always like coming down and checking out these places, especially when there's a roller coaster credit to get. And there it is over in the distance. Fascinating fact for you with that ride, it actually used to be located at Metroland up in Newcastle. There you go, so that's my fascinating fact for you. But yeah, like, I'm gonna head over there and have a little closer look at it.
Right, let's have a nice big thumbs up then, please, if we're all ready to go.
Hey, off we go on Rampage.
For your safety.
Looks like the station building is still in construction. It's not got a roof on at the moment. Here we go. Looks like quite a good layout, this one. Let's go. So, like I say, this used to be at Metroland. It was up Newcastle Way. I think it was in Gateshead, to be exact. I did go there as a kid. It was a long time ago. Quite a nice layout, Zierra Tivoli. But yeah, it closed there in 2008. And then it's been in storage since. Hey, good drop. Opened here in 2016. And it was called The Big One. But it's now been renamed as Rampage. Two lift hills as well. It's got its own lift hill just for that little airtime hill. Obviously this was built for Metroland, which was an indoor theme park. Hey. Really good family coaster. Nice and smooth, nice trains. Hey. Loads of sheep here at the Big Sheep, which I'm glad about. It's not like Flamingo Line where you have to really search for the flamingos. The Big Sheep does have plenty of big sheep. Some sort of combat area over there, like laser tag or something. Battlefield Devon. Whoa. I really like the front train. Nice view down there, the swan boats. Really picturesque park. I like how it's all in the trees. Hey.
Give it some air time, here we go. Hey, you do actually get a bit there as well. And that's it, back into the station. Please without a roof.
Keep your arms in and the train will move further forward and park.
Oh, I like the announcement. When and park.
Closed, please raise your arms whilst we release the lap bars. Thank you.
I love that announcement. That was great, that was.
Well, that was absolutely fantastic. It's definitely one of the best Sierra Tivoli coasters I've ever been on, if not the best one. A lot of them are normally quite shorter than that. And it's got a good length to it, two lift hills. As much as you don't really get loads after that second lift hill, it's more just an airtime hill then back into the brakes and the station. But I was very impressed with that. It's definitely the best coaster I've been on today anyway, out of the four coasters that I've done across both parks. But it's brilliant. You can tell it's been put in here quite recently though. Like, you look at all the foundations and things. I mean, like I say, 2016, it was put in here at the Big Sheep. And from what I know, it was in storage for many years. Obviously, it closed in 2008 when it was at Metroland. It was all indoors and there was a lot of other rides and things around it. Hence why it's got this custom layout. But they've made it work really well here, actually. The fact it's got this big mound in the middle as well. It's nice, I like it. Quite a big coaster to have here. I can see why they call it the biggest coaster in Devon now. And I like the nose car on the front there. Yeah, very enjoyable that was. A brilliant family coaster. Hopefully though, they'll put a roof on that station at some point. Maybe they're just waiting until they've got a bit more money. Because obviously to put in a big coaster like this, especially when it is only a small little farm really with a few other attractions, must have cost them quite a bit of money. But well worth coming along for that one. Good credit. Here I am then on the wave swinger. Whee! I nearly tripped up getting onto this one because the platform is actually quite low for getting onto this. Bit of a different style ride to the normal ones. Yeah, for just some reason I nearly tripped up down there whilst I was getting on. It was like over a metre from the floor onto the chair. Whee, it's a fast swinger this one as well. Soon gets going. What a nice cute little park. I think cute is the word to describe this here. I think it's got a bright future from what I've seen already, to be honest. Really nice. This looks quite new as well. I'm not too sure when this opened, but certainly doesn't look more than a couple of years old. Looks really fresh. Hopefully they'll continue to put more rides in here.
Had a good ride then just on the chair swings. Just having a little stroll around the rest of the park now, see what else there is. And now just spotted this sign down here that says sheep racing here at 3:50 today. That's quite an interesting one. We've got like the animal barn down that way and a few more bits to walk around this side as well. It's a very nicely presented park though. There's all the flower beds everywhere and I really do love how a lot... Hey, oh, there's a sheep, look. Oh my God. Has he run off? Oh, he's run off somewhere. Yeah, I really appreciate these farms that make more of it than just a farm and start adding rides and play areas and other attractions. It's really good. We're seeing it happen a lot now across the UK.
Ladies and gentlemen, boys and girls, we've got the shearing show coming up next.
The shearing show. Oh, there we go.
Get a haircut. We're in the show arena, middle building of the complex, where the sheep is going to get a haircut live on the stage in just a few moments at 2 o'clock.
Well, there you go. Let's have a look in the animal barn. Here we go then. We've got some big sheep just here. Hello. Say hello to the viewers. And then we're going to definitely bring Charlotte in now, look. Because the goats are loose. Hello. Oh. Just roaming free. Hello. Oh. Here we go, and here's the big sheep. Look at this down here, oh my God. Look at the size of these. Oh, he's getting on the side now. Oh, he's coming over the fence here. Oh my God, they want the food now. Hello. You can say hello to all the viewers. Say hello.
They're hungry,
saying it's lunchtime. Oh, this is really nice in here, especially for the kids. And big kids, of course. Oh my God, look at the size of that one. Oh, and all the little babies in there as well. Hello. I can see why they call it the big sheep now. Hello. They all want the limelight. Look at them all lining up to be on the camera. Hello. Oh, and he wants a bit of fame now, don't you? Hiya. Oh, this is great in here. I mean, if you love farm animals, this is the place to go. Oh my God, they're all like loving the GoPro. And some sort of little train ride over here as well. Let's have a little ride on that. Here I am then on the train, got it all to myself, this one. And yeah, it's not got a driver, this train. It's just got a powered track that takes it all the way around the perimeter of the lake just here. All the swan boats. Come on, number five, you're doing a good job. There we are, really nice round here. You got like a trailer there as well. That must be for the tractor ride, wherever that runs. I've not seen that going round though today, but I assume it probably is. And if it is, I'll definitely have a ride on it. But yeah, this looks like it was homemade, this is. I mean, it's all made of wood, which is quite interesting. Just looking at it all, like how it's been put together. That's what I like about stuff like this. It's got a lot of charm to it, a lot of character. Oh, we got a bit of a set piece coming up here on the left-hand side as well, a bit of theming. I can imagine it gets packed here in the holidays and on weekends. There we are, look, Brick Lane. All the little pigs down there, look. Wood Lane, is that Lee Wood Lane, is it? Strawberry Hill. There you go, a little bit of theming as you go round. Oh, and over the bridge we go. Yeah, definitely a homemade ride, this. A little bit bumpy, but I like it. It's got a lot of charm to it. Humpty Dumpty down here. Humpty Dumpty sat on the wall. Humpty Dumpty had a great fall. And there's the Sierra Coaster just over there, Rampage. I'm very much enjoying having a walk around the big sheep. It's always nice discovering somewhere new, and it still seems weird calling it just the big sheep, but I'm getting used to it now. It is quite funny though, isn't it? But at least it lives up to the name. There is some big sheep here. Here's Ram's Hatch then. This is basically like these little go-karts that go round. Then you've got like a soak zone play area down there. There's trampolines up here, and there's some down the bottom there as well. They also have pony rides, but they're not on today. But yeah, it's a really nice little park. It's actually, there's a lot more here than what I was expecting. There's certainly a lot to do. If you've got kids, again, same as the Milky Way, then this will be another full day, really. So you need a full day at both of them, obviously, with me being 25 years old and with these being aimed at families. They're only a few hours each for me. But yeah, it's really nice. It's like a little tractor ride. You see it over there in the distance, where you can actually sit on the back just here and it takes you around this field. But yeah, it's really nice.
ready to go?
Yeah. Hey!
Here we go then, hold on tight. What's wrong?
It's tractor ride time.
I was going to go backwards though. Do you not want to go backwards?
Yeah, I'll go backwards.
Okay, you're in charge. There we go then, that was your tractor ride. How was that? That was good. Off you get then. Bye-bye. You want to go again?
Yeah.
Right, here we go then. Now what?
What a troll.
You want to go forwards again?
Yeah.
Here we go then. There we go then.
I wonder if he does this every time.
Again. Is that far enough? No. Right, we're off. Right then, guys, in case you didn't notice when I was loading you up, my name's Danny. I've got Phoebe in the cab with me as well. Phoebe is on tractor training. So hopefully she'll be driving our nice new tractor fairly soon as well. So we're going to take you for a nice drive out through the farm. Yay! We should see some nice interesting things. Are you warm enough back there, by the way?
Yeah,
we're a bit too warm in here, so I'm just going to turn the air conditioning on. Obviously it won't affect you, but it'll keep us lovely and cool. There is buildings on site, but we've got our very own church just here on the right hand side. It's very holy, our church. That's probably a bit misleading as well, really. When I say holy, it's not religious at all. I mean holy as in the doors have blown off, there's no roof on it. Holy like that, not religious. I should really work on my pronunciation a little bit. Okay then guys, as we're going around this first half, all of our animal fields are on the right hand side. So this here is the first of our animal fields. We've actually got a squirrel sat here on the fence. That's not one of ours. And he's just run off now. He's going to run in front of us. So in this first field we've got three cows, or calves rather. The calves are only 18 months old and they're actually belted Galloways. We've got some Welsh mountain sheep just here. And then we've got Rambo. If you look out there, you'll see a yellow barrel. So yeah, you get a nice view of Mickey's rear end, that's about it. So this next field is our pony field. The ponies would normally be up doing the pony rides, but unfortunately with the heat as it's been, this week and last week we've had to cancel pony rides. It's just not fair on the ponies to be up there at the stables, certainly not all saddled up and taking kids around for a ride. So for this week and last week, pony rides have been cancelled, I'm afraid. Right, now the main reason I wanted to stop, it's so that you can have a closer look, obviously, but also to explain one very strange thing about llamas, and that's that they spit. They're very, very good at spitting. I'm kind of hoping they come right over to the fence, because it makes it much more interesting. What you need to look for is if they fold their ears back, that's them getting ready to spit. If they were stood at the fence, they could spit right the way through the trailer, no problem at all. So I'm quite happy. I've got aircon in here. I'm just going to shut the window. We'll just sit here and wait for a couple of minutes and wait for them to do their thing. It's brilliant fun when they spit at you guys. Not for you lot, obviously, but for us, fantastic. If I'm quick enough as well and get my mobile phone out, it's worth £250 every single time they do it. Come on, girls. I don't even know what they're looking at.
So you just saw some highlights there from the tractor ride. Really good fun, and the guy that was on there was a good laugh, actually. All the little jokes that he was making all the way around. And there you get a good view. It's a shame that, unfortunately, I can't do the laser tag, because as he mentioned on there, it's all privately booked out for a few days. But it's normally included in the price for 10 minutes, and then obviously you can pay a bit extra and have longer on it, which is quite good. But yeah, I've nearly seen everything here now at the Big Sheep. But I just thought I'd show you this here. They've got like all the, are they called hops, I think, for the brewery. There we are, the Country Life Brewery, established 1998, the same year as Oblivion at Alton Towers, there you go. But you can actually taste like all these local beers and stuff just downstairs. Just had a look in the shop just there as well. And it's really nice here. It's a good place to come and check out. I definitely recommend it. Lots of different attractions, a really good price. And what I forgot to mention as well is that when you pay to come in, you can actually come again for free within 7 days as well. So say you're staying in the local area in like a campsite or something, you can come back for free within the week if you want to do the coaster again or the tractor ride. And no, maybe you might want to do it all again. But I think that's really good value. Here we go, it's sheep racing time. I do like the jockeys on the back, they've put some teddies on the back. Oh my god.
Number three has moved in to second place now. It's number three,
number four's in the lead. So as you just saw there, highlights from the sheep racing. How much fun was that? And the fact they put like a little jockey on the back as well. It all kind of adds to it. And it's really good fun. You can actually place bets on them as well. And you get like souvenir merchandise if your sheep wins. I love it. They got a good thing on the go there. But overall, what a lovely place to come and visit. I really enjoyed both of the parts that I've come to today. Like I say, if you've not yet seen it, make sure you check out the vlog from the Milky Way. It was absolutely fantastic. And that's only about 7 miles away. So you can easily do both parks in the same day if you mainly want to get on them roller coasters. If you have got kids, I'd say you probably need a full day at both of them. There's certainly a lot to do at both of the different attractions that I've visited. But they clearly know what they're doing here. I really enjoyed the tractor ride. The roller coaster was fantastic. Great to get on that. And just overall, really friendly staff, good operations. The fact you can come back as well within 7 days is brilliant. But I definitely recommend booking online because it does save a few pounds there with that one. But there you go. Thank you very much for watching another vlog here on Theme Park Worldwide. Always great to see these new theme parks, whether it be farms with roller coasters or full-on theme parks around the world. I love seeing new things, and it certainly is great to bring them to you guys here on Theme Park Worldwide. Tomorrow, I'm going to be heading to Dingle's Heritage Fairground Centre, so I look forward to doing a vlog from there. I'm Sean Sandbrook. Thanks for watching our video here from the Big Sheep, and that means it's time to cue those credits. We'll be right back.